Oh, glory to God. Jesus, bless this message in Jesus' name, I pray. Amen, guys. I'm going to make this quick one here. Daniel chapter 8, start at verse 23. And in the latter time of their kingdom, when the transgressions have reached their fullness, a king shall arise. A king shall arise, having fierce features, who understands sinister schemes. His power shall be mighty, but not by his own power. He shall destroy fearfully and shall prosper and thrive. He shall destroy the mighty and also the holy people. What king just arose, y'all? What king has a lot of power over all the nations, man? That same king that just arose to power. You know who I'm talking about. Hold on. Through his cunning, he shall cause deceit to prosper under his rule. And he shall exalt himself in his heart. He shall destroy many in their prosperity. Because he brings in good stuff, right? He shall even rise against the prince of princes. That's Jesus Christ, man. But he shall be broken without human means, meaning God. This is the Antichrist, y'all. This is the Antichrist. Now, I'm not saying Charles is the Antichrist, but doggone, y'all. I'm going to tell you this. Keep your eyes open. Keep your eyes open. If Charles fits the cup a lot of ways, man. If it ain't Charles, y'all, he knows exactly who it is. But I'm going to tell you something. The dragon gives him his power. The moment that crown went on his head, let me just tell you this. A spirit stepped into that man. Let me tell you this. There has never been, ever, never been a British monarchy, which means king or queen, monarchy, ever stepped foot in Israel, ever. Yeah, Charles went to Israel, but he wasn't a king. He was a prince. There's never been a king step their foot into Israel. This man becomes king. He rises to power. The dragon literally gave him his throne. When he became a prince, he had to face that red dragon. He becomes king. He rises to power. The first thing on his agenda is to go to Israel and try to make a two-state solution, peace with Israel and the Palestinians. There's already 10 kings out there. Let's read this again. In the latter time of their kingdom, verse 23, when the transgressors have reached their fullness, a king shall arise, having fierce features, who understands sinister schemes. His power shall be mighty, but not by his own power. He shall destroy fearfully and shall prosper and thrive. Now listen, and he who the church has been telling you ain't here for this, that we already gone up out of here? We're not, y'all. And he, who, this man of sin, shall destroy the mighty and also the holy people. You guys, what God has been showing me the past 3 years, why do you think he's been warning me about all these signs of his return coming? Earthquakes, volcanoes, this and that, you know, all this destruction, storms intensifying and increasing. We've been watching it. Collapsing, our money's collapsing. Look what's going on, you guys. A king has risen to power. First thing on his agenda is to go to Israel and try to make peace, while the Pope at the same time is going to Russia and Ukraine to try to make peace over there. Do you see what's going on here, you guys? Persecution's about to come for the church. Why do you think God has been saying, children, rise up? Rise up. Get your armor on. Get out of the woe is me self-pity mode. Start being the body of Christ, man. Ain't no dead soldiers laying around in God's kingdom, y'all. You got to stand up. You're going to have to get your armor on. And this ain't to be scared, y'all. We're about to go meet Jesus. You understand that? You about to go meet Jesus. We're about to see him. Okay? I'm about to see him again. He's coming. I've done did. Are we in the tribulation video? Go look at it. The third day, 2030 marks the third day. I done showed you where we're in an extended grace period, according to Psalms chapter, 90, I think. When Israel becomes a nation, that generation will not pass away. 70 years as a generation. That was in 2018. We're in that 10-year extended grace period he talks about. Could be 80, right? We're in that extended grace. Y'all, it's happening, y'all. Do you understand this? So God has been trying to get you guys to stand up, rise up, start obeying him and things, put stuff of this world down, start obeying him. Why you ain't never heard a pastor out here talk like me? Because you ain't heard one out here that met Jesus in the last days. Children, rise up in the name of Jesus. Put your armor on. Build your faith and get excited. Get excited because you're about to go home. Y'all, you're about to meet Jesus. And to go home, it's not a curse to leave this earth, y'all. It's not a curse. But tell you what, you're worrying about your family and your kids, then you better rise up and be a Christian in front of them. That's what we do. All right? God bless you. I'll be back later with the lesson. In Jesus' name, give your life to Jesus. Start obeying him. Make him Lord of your life, y'all. In Jesus' name. All right, anything you need is in the description. Thank those of you that's doing your first fruits. That is Day of Pentecost. That's on the 28th. Thank those of you that's obeying God in that area. All right, and thank the rest of you for your normal stuff. Thank y'all. God bless you. I'll see y'all in a bit.